यस, टेक्सटाइल फाइबर्स ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, नेचुरल फाइबर्स एंड मैनमेड फाइबर्स. नेचुरल फाइबर्स आर दोज फाइबर्स विच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम नेचुरल सोर्सेस डायरेक्टली इन द फाइबर फॉर्म, एंड मैनमेड फाइबर्स विच वी आर सिंथेसाइजिंग और विच वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इन द इंडस्ट्रीज. सो द फाइबर विच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम नेचर आर कॉल्ड नेचुरल फाइबर्स एंड द फाइबर्स विच वी आर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग आर नोन एज मैन मेड फाइबर्स, मीन्स मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाई मैन. नेचुरल फाइबर्स आर क्लासीफाइड इंटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, एनिमल फाइबर्स, वेजिटेबल फाइबर्स एंड मिनरल फाइबर्स. एनिमल फाइबर्स आर दोज फाइबर्स विच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम एनिमल्स, वेजिटेबल फाइबर्स विच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड मिनरल फाइबर्स डायरेक्टली वी आर गेटिंग इन द नेचर फ्रॉम द माइनिंग पार्ट. मैनमेड फाइबर्स आर ब्रॉडली कैटेगराइज इंटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, रीजनरेटेड फाइबर्स, सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड इनऑर्गेनिक फाइबर्स. आउट ऑफ दीज थ्री कैटेगरीज फॉर अवर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, फ्रॉम टेक्सटाइल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, दीज टू कैटेगरीज आर इम्पॉर्टेंट, रीजनरेटेड एंड सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स. एनिमल फाइबर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर रिसोर्सेज फर्दर क्लासिफाइड इंटू टू कैटेगरीज, यस, हेयर फाइबर्स एंड सेक्रीशन फाइबर्स. हेयर फाइबर्स विच वी आर गेटिंग एज द आउटर सर्फेस ग्रोथ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हेयर्स फ्रॉम द आउटर सर्फेस ऑफ द एनिमल्स और स्किन ऑफ द एनिमल्स. सो दीज द एग्जाम्पल्स आर वूल विच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम शीप, मोहेयर फ्रॉम, दीज आर मोहेयर, कैशमीरे, दीज आर वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ गोट्स. कैमल हेयर is also used as fiber because it is having the required properties which should be contained by a fiber. Horse hair, a rabbit hair and alpaca, these are the examples of hair fibers. Secretion fibers, there is only one example of that, that is silk, which we are getting from silk worm. Wool we are getting from sheep, mohair and cashmere we are getting from goat, camel hair from camel, horse hair from horse, rabbit hair from rabbit, and alpaca, that is a particular type of animal we are producing alpaca type of hairs, which is come in the category of hair animal fibers. In secretion category, there is only silk, which is secreted from silkworm, mouth of silkworm, a liquid is secreted, and that's why this is known as secretion fiber, because it is secreting from the mouth of this silkworm. And it is produced in the form of filament because it is having very, very high length. The length is in hundreds of meters, and that type of fiber is termed as filament. So this is the only fiber in the natural category which we are getting in the filament form. All we are getting in fiber form, means having limited length. Then vegetable fibers, also known as plant fibers, which we are getting from plants, and because the basic material is cellulose, so these fibers is containing raw material, that is cellulose. So vegetable fibers are further classified into four categories: seed fibers, bast fibers, leaf fibers and fruit fibers. So from the name it is clear from which part of the plant we are getting these fibers. According to the name of the part of the plant, we are categorizing them into different categories. So seed fibers we are getting from seeds. The growth of the fibers is on the seed, they are adhered to the seed, so we are removing them by a process that is known as ginning. So with the help of ginning, seeds are extracted, seed fibers are extracted, which are adhered to the seed as the outer growth, and these are known as seed fibers. examples of seed fibers, a very popular example is cotton, which is very highly used fiber. Kapok is another example, and bombex is a third example of seed fiber. So cotton, kapok, and bombex comes in the category of seed fibers. Bast fibers. Bast comes from bark, and this fiber is also known as stem fibers because we are getting this from stem. Stem means tana. जो पेड़ का तना है उसमें जो बार्क होती है उसके नीचे ये फाइबर्स होते हैं, एंड दैट्स व्हाई ड्यू टू दिस बार्क द टर्म्स कम्स दैट इज बास्ट, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे आर नोन एज बास्ट फाइबर्स. एंड एग्जांपल्स आर जूट, हेम्प, लिनेन. लिनेन इज आल्सो नोन एज फ्लैक्स, रेमी, केनाफ एंड सन. दीज आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ बास्ट फाइबर्स व्हिच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम द स्टेम ऑफ द प्लांट. Found under the bark or bast, that's why they are known as bast fibers. Seed which are adhered to the sheath known as seed fibers. Leaf fibers which we are getting from the leaves of the plants, and examples are sisal, manila and pineapple. Generally students get confused with pineapple and they are taking pineapple as the example of fruit, but this is not a fruit fiber. We are getting this fiber from the leaves of pineapple plant. So this we are not getting from fruit of pineapple. This is we are getting from leaf. So we were taking leaf fibers. Examples are sisal, manila and pineapple. So remember, this pineapple comes in the category of leaf because we are getting pineapple fibers from the leaves of the plant of pineapple. Another category is fruit fibers, which we are getting from the fruits, and that's why this is known as fruits. So betel nut, palm nut, and one example is not written here, you can note down. That is coir, C-O-I-R, coir. Coir we are getting from the coconut. The outer covering of the coconut, that is husk of the coconut, those are used as the fiber and they are known as coir fiber. That is also one example of this fruit fiber. So here we have taken seed fibers, bast fibers, leaf fibers and fruit fibers. I think Berulal is having some question. Berulal, want to ask some question? Or we can take later on at the end. Berulal, you are listening me? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can we take the questions at the end? You just note down.
No, sir.
You are raising the hand. It is showing that you are raising the hand.
No, sir. Okay.
No issue. ठीक है. So ये clear है. Seed fibers. Bast fibers, leaf fibers and fruit fibers. These are the four categories of vegetable fibers. And mineral fibers is not having any category, only two examples. One is written here, that is asbestos, that comes under the category of mineral fibers, and another is silica. But these are not generally used for textile purposes, so these are not very important from our point of view, from textile point of view. From our point of view, among these fibers, wool, silk, cotton, jute, linen, Yeah, these are the important textile fibers which are generally used for apparel purposes. So this is all about natural fibers, animal, vegetable, mineral, and their categories. All these fibers are produced by nature in the fiber form itself. What we are doing, what man is doing, we are extracting them from the nature as it is in the fiber form, and that's why they are known as natural fibers. And they are strength providing skeleton of the plants. These are not produced for us, actually we are using them, but generally nature produce it to provide strength to that particular part of the plant. So these are providing strength, these are strength providing skeletons, and these we are extracting. Seed fibers are extracted from seed by the process of ginning. Bast fibers are extracted from bast or stem of the plants, leaf fibers from the leaves, and fruit fibers, that is outer covering of the fruits, that is extracted and used for textile purposes. Similarly, we are extracting or we are cutting the hair growth of the animals and using them as a fiber known as hair fibers in the category of animal. Similarly, the liquid secreted, and after secretion it gets solidified and converted into filament. That filament is used for textile purposes and comes in the category of natural animal fibers. Now we will learn about man-made fibers. Man-made fibers, we are showing three categories, but these two are more important for us: regenerated fibers and synthetic fibers. Here the basic difference between these two, both comes in the category of man-made fibers. So the basic difference is regenerated fibers we are getting from natural polymer, whereas synthetic fibers which we are getting from synthetic polymer. Synthetic polymers which is manufactured from some monomers which we are getting from petroleum products. So those monomers are converted into polymer, that is synthesized into polymer. So the raw material is monomer. These monomers join together to form a polymer, and this polymer is converted into filament form and then converted into fiber form. It is known as synthetic fiber. So synthetic fiber means it is 100% manufactured by man. Means we are extracting, we are getting monomers from the nature, but these monomers are converted into polymer. So this is synthetic polymer. And then this synthetic polymer is converted into filament or fiber form. So this is known as synthetic fibers. Whereas regenerated fibers, which we are getting from natural polymer, means here we are not manufacturing polymer. Polymer we are extracting from nature. So that's why this is known as, also known as natural polymer based fibers. So these we are getting the raw material from the nature, but not in the fiber form. What is the difference in natural and regenerated? Let it clear, because generally students get confused. Natural fibers we are getting from nature already in the fiber form, but regenerated fibers we are getting the polymer from the nature in other form, like wood. We are getting, wood is containing cellulose, so wood we are getting from nature. So already we are getting the polymer in the wood. Now this wood is converted into filament or fiber form through some process. So half the work is done by nature, means the formation of polymer is done by nature, but the conversion of this polymer into fiber is done by man, or by some process, by using some manufacturing process, we are producing this. And that's why this is known as regenerated, because the polymer we are getting from nature in another form, and this form is again converted into some liquid form, and then it is passed through some fine holes or spinneret and converted into filament form or fiber form. So we are regenerating the same material. In the beginning we have cellulose, we convert it into some other chemical, then again we are regenerating cellulose. If we are having protein, we are converting them into some other chemicals, and then we are again regenerating proteins. So regeneration word we are using due to regeneration of the same polymeric material which we are getting from nature. What we are doing, we are converting the form. Suppose it is in wood form, we are converting into filament or fiber form. And that's why they are known as semi-synthetic also. Semi-synthetic means half synthetic and half nature. Half nature because polymer is produced by nature. Polymer we are getting from nature, and this polymer is converted into filament or fiber form. Whereas in synthetic, we are forming the polymer and then we are converting into filament form. So I think I have cleared the definition, regenerated and synthetic. Now regenerated are classified into two categories, cellulosic and protein. Cellulosic fibers further categorized into three categories, pure cellulosic, modified cellulosic, and another category which is not coming into either pure cellulosic or modified cellulosic, they are put in the third category, that is miscellaneous category. Examples of pure cellulosic, viscose rayon, cupra ammonium rayon, which is also known as cupra, and polynosic. So these three are the examples of pure cellulosic fibers. Then modified cellulosic means cellulose is modified into some other chemical form, and then we are converting them into fiber form. So here cellulose is modified and they become modified cellulosic. Examples are dicel and tricel. Dicel is known as diacetate rayon and tricel is known as triacetate rayon. We will take them in detail also. And in the miscellaneous category, only one example is there, that is alginate fibers. So this is all about cellulosic regenerated fibers. Now protein fibers in the category of regenerated, again they are classified into two categories. Protein means these are amide fibers. Polyamide is the name of the polymer. So protein classified into two categories, vegetable fibers and animal fibers. In examples of vegetable protein regenerated fiber is vicara and ardil, and animal casein. This is extracted from milk, casein fiber. So this comes in the category of animal because milk we are getting from animal and this casein is extracted from milk. So this comes in the category of animal protein regenerated fibers. Whereas vicara and ardil comes in the category of vegetable protein regenerated fibers. Now further categories of synthetic fibers, there are many categories. Out of those, we are taking some important categories here. So first is polyamide, means this is from the name of the polymer. Here the name of the polymer is polyamide. The polyamide is converted into filament or fiber form through some processes, through some spinning processes. We have different spinning processes which we will take later on. So from these spinning processes, this polyamide is converted into polyamide fibers, and examples are nylon 6 and nylon 66, which is very highly used, particularly for socks and industrial uses. Another is polyesters, which is also very famous fiber, very popular fiber and most widely used fiber due to its higher strength and low cost. Examples are terylene and dacron. In the category of polyester, two examples we have taken, terylene and dacron. Another category is polyolefins. Examples are meraculone and heruculone. Polyurethane examples are lycra, spandex and wiring. Lycra is very popular fiber nowadays. It is particularly known for its high elastic properties. So to produce a very elastic textile materials, sometimes we use a little bit portion of lycra, which is blended at the stage of yarn. One ply of lycra is used along with spun yarns, and it gives very high elastic property to that fiber or to that yarn or to that textile material. So to produce a very elastic textile materials, these polyurethane fibers, and from this category, lycra is very popular in the industry nowadays. Another category is synthetic rubber. Example is plastic fibers. And then next category is polyvinyl derivatives. In polyvinyl derivatives, we have further categories. So we have taken four categories of polyvinyl, that is polyacrylonitrile, PAN fibers, PAN, polyacrylonitrile, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polyvinyl alcohol, and polytetrafluoroethylene. These are the four categories comes under polyvinyl derivatives. Examples of polyacrylonitrile is Orlon, ड्रेलॉन और पीवीसी, पॉलीविनाइल क्लोराइड, विनियन एंड रोविल, पॉलीविनाइल अल्कोहल पीवीए, विनिलॉन एंड क्यूरेलॉन. दिस मीटिंग विल एंड इन 10 मिनट्स, सो वी विल ट्राई टू कवर दिस क्लासिफिकेशन. देन पॉलीटेट्राफ्लुरोइथिलीन एंड एग्जाम्पल इज टेफ्लोन. So these are the this is the basic classification of textile fibers, particularly on the basis of resources. Resources means from which we are getting the fiber. So overall classification we have taken. Examples of inorganic fibers are glass, silica, metal, viscose, carbon, ceramic. These are the examples of inorganic fibers, which is generally used for as a modified fibers nowadays, but not for general textile purposes. So this is all about this slide. Yes, textile fibers. This is another classification, but this is just, you can say, a brief classification on the basis of the broad classification which we have taken right now. So here it is classification based on chemical nature or chemical structure. So the same classification is converted into another form. So this we also will go through. This is based on this classification is based on chemical nature. So here we are taking basic chemical natures of different fibers and categorizing them. So the fibers, like this is cellulosic fiber, modified cellulosic fibers, polyamide fibers, and then these are different category like polyester, polyacrylonitrile, polyvinyl alcohol, mod acrylic, polyolefin, polyurethane, which we have taken in the synthetic category. So cellulosic fibers further classified into three categories. Natural fibers are also having cellulosic base, semi-synthetic fibers also having cellulosic as the raw material, cellulose as the raw material, and some miscellaneous fibers also having cellulose as the raw material. The fibers which are having cellulose as the raw material are put in the category of cellulosic fibers, like natural fibers, cotton, flax, jute, all the bast fibers and leaf fibers and fruit fibers can put in the category of natural. Here I have taken only limited examples, 5 examples: cotton, flax, jute, hemp, remi, which are very popular fibers in the category of natural. But you can put all the natural fibers which are vegetable resources, plant resources, seed fibers, seed fibers, leaf fibers, bast fibers, and fruit fibers. They can put in the category of natural cellulosic fibers. In semi-synthetic or semi-synthetic cellulosic fibers, viscose rayon, cupramonium rayon, polynosic rayon, all can be put in the semi-synthetic cellulosic category. And miscellaneous alginate can put in the category of cellulose. So these all are having cellulose as the base, so they are put in the category of cellulosic textile fibers. Modified cellulosic fibers, already we have taken the category, that is dicel and tricel. They come in the category of modified cellulosic. So as it is, you can take from the previous chart. Then another chemical structure, main chemical structure found in the textile fibers, is polyamide. So polyamide again put in the three categories: natural polymer, that is regenerated, and synthetic. So in the natural, wool and silk are the examples of natural polyamide fibers, whereas vicara, ardil, and casein are the examples of natural polymer based polyamide fibers. And in the category of synthetic, polyamide nylon 6 and nylon 66 can be put in the category of polyamide textile fibers. Then there are separate categories: polyester, polyacrylonitrile, PVA, mod acrylic, polyolefin, polyurethane, and other categories which you have taken in the previous chart can be taken here as a category of different fibers, because they are having their own chemical nature. Polyester is having ester, polyacrylonitrile is having acrylonitrile groups, polyvinyl alcohol is having vinyl alcohol, acrylic, polyolefins are having olefin, polyurethane is having urethane as the chemical structure. So they are separate categories. So here this is another classification of textile fibers. So now we have only 5 minutes left, so I think we will start the next topic in the next class on tomorrow. So We have 5 minutes. If you have any question related with classification, this chart of classification, that is very important chart, and I will suggest you after the class, you try to understand it, try to get some questions also, if you have any query, if it is not clear, and try to remember this classification chart, because this classification chart will be used again and again in this semester, as well as in the coming semesters, or maybe in the your placement interviews also. So from that point of view, up to the placement interviews, this topic is generally used. And because if you know the classification, then you can know something, you can say something about that particular fiber. Like if it is a category of vegetable fibers, then they have certain similarities in the properties. If they are from animal resources, or if they are from polyamide resources, then certain similarities will be there. So this classification chart is very important for all of you. So please try to remember this classification chart whenever you have the time after the class. Or any confusion in the classification chart about some exam file or some category, you can ask, because I think we have only 3 minutes left. Yes, Bhavesh, you have some question? Bhavesh? Anyone else?
Sir.
Yes.
So what kind of mineral fibers are present?
Examples.
Examples.
Examples, I have taken asbestos, one is, and another is silica.
Silica.
Yes, silica and asbestos.
Sir, asbestos are used in which area? Means
not in textile, not for textile purposes. But this is actually fulfilling the quality of textile fibers, the length L by D ratio and certain properties. That's why this we have taken into classification. But generally, it is not used for most of the textile uses.
Okay, sir.
Yes, the popular fibers I have already taken into consideration, that your animal fiber, in the animal fibers, wool and silk are the most commonly used fibers. And we will go into the detail of wool and silk in the coming lectures. In the category of vegetable fibers, cotton, jute, and linen, flax or linen are the important fibers. So we will take them into details. And then in the category of regenerated, viscose rayon and acetate rayon, we will take into detail. And they are very popular fibers and important fibers from textile purposes. And in the category of synthetic fibers, we will take polyamide fibers, nylon 6, nylon 66, and polyester into details. So I think our time is over, because this Zoom app gives us only 40 minutes for the maximum limit is 40. Otherwise, we have to upgrade the app, and that requires some money or some financial involvement is there. And I think that much time is enough. So today we have covered two types of classification. One is on the basis of resources. Another is on the basis of chemical nature. And the first classification is very important. So just go through this classification again and again and try to remember it. You can cram it, cramming, and you are expert in cramming. So cram it. Generally, question is asked on the basis of classification. Classify the fiber, textile fibers, on the basis of resources and give at least one or two examples. So in most of the cases, I have given 2-3 examples, but at least one example should be mentioned and maybe asked in the question. So generally, question is based on classification is having examples of each category also. Yes, I will share. I will share. Definitely, I will share. After every class, I will share. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have one more doubt of previous lecture.
You can ask me on WhatsApp personally.
Sir, I have sent.
Yeah, or also on the group also. Wherever you found suitable, you can ask.
No, sir. I have sent the question to you before only.
You have sent?
You have not checked. Okay, yes, sir.
So send me again. Or it will be better if you send me on my personal box. It will be better, because generally in the group, sometimes I'm not reading all the
no, sir.
All the chats.
I have sent in personal chat only.
Okay, I will see.
You have not seen till yet.
Answer you after the class, okay?
Okay, sir.
ओके थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू
एंड किसी ने वो इसका स्क्रीनशॉट लेने के लिए बोला था मैंने पार्थ आपको टीसी के लिए
यस सर ले लिया
और गौरव